Generals, fellow soldiers, ladies and gentlemen, it's a very big pleasure to be here and to be able to talk a little bit about what we are doing right at this moment. Ben is very strict. He keeps me to the 10 minutes. That's why I skipped the joke. Which should probably have gone about us not participating at the World Championships of Soccer. And the Germans always poke us in the eye for that. But then we realized that right now, actually, you have the same amount of points during the World Championships and played one game less. We're in the same boat. ladies and gentlemen, if you want to learn for the future, you have to look back to the past. And I'll just go to the next slide, if that works. Yeah. And as many armies, many armed forces in the world, we have three main tasks, which is, first of all, to defend our nation and our allied territory. Second is to bring stability. And the third is to support our civil authorities. In the last 20 years, due to operational tempo, we focused our training more and more on stability operations. And due to budget restrictions, we more and more went away from the heavy materiel. We just sold most of our main battle tanks just before Russia invaded Crimea. And it still hurts a little bit when I participate in an exercise as a loader on a former Dutch tank in a Finnish exercise, although they're very well taken care of. Thank you very much for that. But the downing, especially of the MH17, made the people in the Netherlands realize that it's not all about peace in the world, it's all about sometimes war in the world. And that made us change our focus from the second task to the first task without skipping the second one. So we still do stability operations, but we focus more and more on high intensity conflict, which is not the same as the old Cold War, but that is quite clear. If you look at our toolbox at the moment, in our maneuver forces, we have a heavy brigade with CV-90s, and together with Germany, we participate with one company in a German tank battalion that can participate in this brigade. So we have some tanks left. We have a light changing to medium brigade with the Boxer, and we have the air assault brigade with Apaches and Chinooks as main weapon systems. Next to that, the Special Forces Regiment. We put all our support, combat support and combat service support, in our operational support brigade. Next to that, we have several commands of air defense and the cyber command, still with the army, but changing to the CHOT in a few weeks. This toolkit actually fits the purpose, more or less. But it's certainly not big enough, and it's certainly not sharp enough. And a new white paper gave us the opportunity to change some things. We have an increase in budget of 18%. A lot of the money is spent on replacing capabilities, but we also spend money on restoring the balance, because in this toolkit they have not enough combat support and not enough combat service support to support all the maneuver. So that has to change to be able to operate. And we invest heavily on information technology and also on personnel, and that is quite important. If we just go over the restoration of the balance, I don't explain all these things, but it's all about command and control, ISTAR, RECI, artillery air defense, engineers, CRBN, and explosive ordnance device. It's logistics, it's reception, staging, onward movement, and medical support. And not necessarily we buy the same equipment we have now to have more. We look at the need, and we look at capabilities available to improve, and that's for all the things we are going to replace. But the next stop is not repairing the balance. The next stop is to restore fighting power, combat power. We had an exercise with a full mechanized brigade last year. We went to Poland because then you also train on the deployment over longer distances and over borders. But we found out, and we did it with our partners with Germany, Norway, Belgium, Poland, France, and some others. And you find out that deployment is complex. We forgot a lot of what we knew almost by heart a long time ago. And it's not only complex, it also doesn't work as it used to. If you now ask the railway to transport yourself, you find yourself back 3 weeks later than you planned. If you go for battle, that's not acceptable. We did not only test the physical landscape, as we call it, we also tested the information landscape and the human landscape. We used the cyber devices to track people, and we saw them on their telephones, and they were all killed instantly in the first action. The second run, nobody took his mobile telephone with them, which means you can influence people quite easily and quite fast. And that's only a simple example of how you can use your information technology. Next week, this brigade will do a new experiment in a simulator, and we look at the deep battle against a modern enemy division. And we first will do that with the current equipment. The outcome is most likely that we will lose, to be honest. But we will have to find out what we have to change to be able to win that battle. And for certain, without doing the experiment, elements of the answer will be we need better command and control, we need better intelligence, we need longer range, more precision, and the sensor-to-shooter time has to be shorter. We will have to disperse to survive, but we will have to have mass effects to win. And all other things that come out of that experiment. Because it will be, if we bring a brigade or more brigades to the fight, it will always be joined, it will always be combined, and it will always be interagency. Think about hybrid warfare. International, we never do something alone. We very close operate with Germany, with our brigades under command of their divisions, but also air defense under our command. We work together with Norway and Germany in the VGTF, and together with France with the 13th Brigade connected to the 9th Brigade. And of course, we very much appreciate the support we get from the US and the UK, especially on the support on the country by doctrine and knowledge. And if you work internationally, it's all about interoperability. That having said, is not only equipment, it's also doctrine and the will to work together, but equipment can help you, especially in the way of command and control, to exchange data. And it's also helpful if your equipment doesn't look the same, but is the same. And our engineers always try to find 5% improvement because we have the world's best. Only poor thing is that I cannot use it together with somebody else. So I rather have 98% that can work together easily with somebody else. And what we also learned is we have to bring back our host nation support capability. It's not that we drive our units to the east or to the south or to somewhere in Europe and start fighting. There are others coming from overseas, and we have to have backfill, which has to land somewhere in Europe. Could be in the Netherlands, and then we have to support the critical infrastructure and support the units to move to wherever the battle is. If you look forward to 25, we are looking at some developments, and I must say, I'm really, when I listen to all the briefings today, almost everything is already on our mind. Certainly we did not solve everything yet, but at least I don't think we forgot anything, and that's quite reassuring. But these, I don't mention all of them, are the fields that we are going as an army to experiment in. We do not do that separately somewhere where nobody sees it, but connected to our maneuver units so that they can see, feel, and live it, and participate if they have good ideas. And of course, that's orchestrating capacity, for the overwhelming knowledge that we have to bring to the right place. I want to say something about robotics. Robotics is not only technology. Robotics is necessary because we will have fewer people in the Netherlands in a few years. At this moment, the 27-year-olds are 225,000. The 2-year-olds are 175,000, which is substantially less. In a competitive world where healthcare, education, police, building is concentrating. I have only 1 minute to finalize. Cyber, big data, autonomous logistics, which is not on the slide. We are not going to do that alone. We have to be adaptive and use the power of society and industry to help us. And that's not only, it's also the brain power. We have to implement new ideas, new technology, and organizations. And maybe that's the hardest part. Because a lot of the things that we mentioned today are there already, but we didn't implement it yet, because that's quite hard. But in the end, it's all about the people in the army. This is our biggest assets for the years to come, and we have to take care of them. Thank you very much.